Janet sat at the window stitching the hem of her green dress. She looked out towards Carter Howe. Carter Howe was a beautiful and mysterious place. A hill, with gorse and broom, roses and other flowers. But it was a place where many people were forbidden to go, especially the young people. It was strongly believed that the elven folk lived beneath Carter Howe. It was also strongly believed that people who went missing were taken by the elven folk. It was said that those elven folk had to pay a tithe to the devil every 7 years, and that they would steal young, helpless humans to give to the devil. But there were strong-willed people and people that liked a challenge or a dare, and they would go to the well at Carter Howe, and there they would leave gifts, gold and silver trinkets for the elven folk, in hopes that they wouldn't be taken away. Janet had lost her friend, Tam Lin. They had grown up together. They were the closest of friends, and because their parents knew each other, they had agreed that Tam Lin and Janet would be married. But one day, whilst Tam Lin was out hunting with his father, Tam Lin, the young prince, had taken off after this hart, this beautiful, great stag, on his own. When they found his horse, there was no sign of Tam Lin, and the horse they found at Carter Howe, tied to the well there. But that was years ago. If he hadn't been stolen away by the Fae, then it wouldn't be long before Janet and Tam Lin would have been married. And these were the thoughts that were going through her head as she sewed the hem of her green dress and looked out towards Carter Howe. Janet set down her needlework, stood up, and made a decision. Yes, it had been years, but yes, maybe there was a chance that she'd find him there. If it were the elven folk that had taken Tam Lin, maybe her prince would have escaped by now. So she went to the stables, saddled up a horse, and rode to that hill. When she got there, she tied up her horse, just as Tam Lin had done, to the well, and started walking around. She called out his name, but no answer came. But the broom, those beautiful yellow flowers, they were open, and she picked one and placed it in her hair, wondering if it would make a nice headdress for a wedding. She picked a second flower, and then behind her she heard a voice. "What gives you the right to take my flowers? What gives you the right to break my broom?" "My father owns this land, and this land I'll inherit. I do not need anyone's permission to pick flowers," she said, turning around. And who was there? Tam Lin. Her eyes widened, her mouth opened. "My love, Tam Lin." "Janet. Janet." They embraced. They held each other close. "Where have you been, Tam Lin? Where have you been all these years? Have you been hiding from me?" "No, no, of course not." "Did you not hear? Did people not tell you what happened?" "Well, they said that you were missing, that they found your horse at Carter Howe, but they never found you." "Aye. I was chasing this beautiful white hart. Oh, it was magnificent. And it led me round Carter Howe 3 times with a shins. And on the 3rd time round, I got sleepy. So I tied up the horse right where you tied yours up. And I lay down and I slept. And when I awoke, I was in the land of the elven people. At first, I thought my life was threatened. I thought I was done for. But the queen, she took a liking to me. So I was safe. So come away with me now." "I cannot, Janet. There's a spell put upon me. I cannot leave this place." "Why not?" "Because I can't, Janet. I'm stuck here." "Well, how did you get to be here now?" "Because you broke the flowers, Janet. The only time I can come up out of the fairy mound, is if someone breaks the flowers. Not once, but twice." "And you did that?" He took her in her hand, and the two of them laid down in the long grass. When she stood up, she kissed Tam Lin. "Is there no way I can help you? Is there no way that I can free you from this place? We were promised each other, and I love you with all my heart. I can't stand it to think that you'll be back down there with the Queen." "Well, Janet, there is one thing. There is one thing that might help me, that might save me. 2 nights from now, it's Halloween. Come back here, before midnight. Bring with you some holy water. What you'll have to do is come to this very spot that we sit in right now. And with that holy water, make a circle around you, make a compass around you. And wait. Because between 12 and 1, the hillside will open up and 3 troops of the elven folk will come out. The first will be black. Let them ride by. Then brown horses with the elven folk on them will ride by. Let them go past too. The third troop will be riding white horses. I'll be riding my own mount next to the Queen. She doesn't like me to get too far away from her. I'll be wearing one glove. And that hand that has no glove on it, it'll be next to you. And using that hand, you have to pull me from the horse, pull me into that circle of water. The Queen, she'll be furious. She'll throw spells. The others will throw spells. They'll change me into 3 things. I don't know what they'll be. But you'll have to hold on to me tight. Of course I'll hold on to you tight. No, you don't understand. So tight that I cannot break free. You'll have to be strong, you have to be brave. What do you think? You think I'm not strong, you think I'm not brave? I'm here on my own, aren't I? Aye, Janet, you are. And I love you for it. The last thing that they'll turn me into is a red hot sword. As soon as I become the sword, you're to throw me in the well. And I'll climb back out, like a naked born baby. Have your green mantle. Wear that. Wrap it around me when I come out of the well. And then, and only then, will we be safe. I'll do that for you, Tam Lin. I will. She kissed him again. But when she opened her eyes, Tam Lin was gone. She rode back to her home and found a small glass bottle. She then filled it with holy water and waited. All Hallows' Eve. Her parents were having a party. It was easy to sneak out. And she rode a horse back to Carter Howe, with a green mantle, her green cloak about her, and the bottle of water in her hand. She once again tied a horse up at the well, and she watched the stars twinkling in the sky. She waited and she waited, and she heard the church bells chime midnight. And she waited and she waited, and she saw the moon rising full in the sky. And she waited, and she waited, and she heard the rumbling of the side of the hill, and she saw black horses riding out, mounted by the elven folk. She let them pass by. Then another troop of horses came by, ridden by the elven folk. These were riding brown horses, and she let them ride by. And then finally, out from the hill, came a troop of elven folk riding white horses. And she saw Tam Lin there, in amongst them. Next to him rode the Queen on her high horse. Her face was haughty, her lips thin, her eyes steel and cold. She saw Tam Lin's ungloved hand. And as he got close to that circle that she had surrounded herself in, she reached up and she grabbed hold of that hand and pulled him within the circle. She grabbed hold of her true love and held him tight.
"Tam Lin! Tam Lin! Alas has borrowed him, he is gone!"
The elven queen screamed out into the night. The elves turned and looked at Janet, holding on to her Tam Lin. The queen pointed her finger at Tam Lin, and the prince started to change shape. She held on tight as his body shifted and twisted and turned into a snake. It was huge. Its fangs dripped venom. But when she placed her hand against the snake's neck, It did no harm to her.
Save Tam Lin!
Screamed the queen again, and she pointed her finger at Tam Lin once more, and the snake twisted and writhed, but she held tightly onto it, and it turned into a swan, and she grabbed it by its feet whilst its wings beat her about the head and face.
You'll not take my Tam Lin, said the queen.
She pointed at Tam Lin once more, and Janet felt him turning and twisting in her grip. She got a better hold of the creature it turned into, and soon she saw that it was a wolf with huge canine teeth barking and snapping, but not at her. She sank her fingers deep into the fur and held the beast tight and would not let it go. The queen screamed once more, and the wolf slowly turned into a red-hot sword. But Tam Lin had promised not to hurt her, and so the sword did not harm her in any way. She threw it into the well, and it landed into the water with a great hiss, and steam rose up. The elven folk rode hard on their horses around that circle that she had drawn herself. Tam Lin came out as naked as a newborn baby, and she threw her cape, her mantle, around him and pulled him within the circle. The queen rode her horse up to Tam Lin, up to the edge of that circle of water.
If I had known, Tam Lin, that a lady would borrow thee, I would have taken out your eyes and left two of three. If I had known what I know now before that we'd left home, I'd have taken out your heart of flesh and left a heart of stone. If I'd known yesterday what I know today, I'd have given you long ago to pay the tithe, the devil's pay.
And with that, the elven queen screamed one more time and rode off with her host into the night for the great hunt. Janet helped Tam Lin back home, and there she nursed him back to health. And once he was back on his feet again, there was a marriage between Tam Lin and Janet. And I like to think that they spent the rest of their days in happiness and prosperity.